Hi, Aquarius. Welcome to your reading. All right, we're reading for the latter half of November. Universe, Angel, Spirit Guides, what's going on the last week of November, please, going into December? For my beautiful aquas. Let's see, guys, what's happening here. Sorry for the lighting. I know it could be better, but I'm in a dark little corner of my house. And it's nighttime, so I don't have the best of lighting. Sorry about that. But let's see what's going on with you, especially post-eclipse. I've been very curious to see how every zodiac has handled it. Wow. Okay, I don't know if you know me as a reader. I don't sugarcoat anything. I tell it like it is. Why? Because pretend I'm your best friend. Pretend I'm your older sister. Pretend I'm sitting at the other end of your couch and I'm guiding you. Because tarot is meant to be a tool to be used to mitigate fallout or to deal with our problems. Also, the channel's enlightenment. It's meant to work on ourselves, our shadow side, our north node, whatever crap gets thrown in our way, how to deal with it and how to process. What's coming towards them? Anything special? Seriously? What's coming towards Aquarius, please? Because this looks pretty significant to me, Spirit. Oh, I see. What don't they see coming? What's the surprise then? Okay, your cards have a lot of explanation because your situation was very interesting to me, and all the cards that are following now are telling me why you're in this situation that you're in, and it's explaining quite a bit. It's not really telling me about the crossing energy or like the people that you're dealing with. It's just telling me more about you, if anything at all. Let's see what your advice is over here. Advice, please, for Aquarius. Interesting. Outcome for Aquarius, please. Outcome. Too many. You guys are dealing with some kind of burden that you're struggling to like get detached from. Overall theme and the cards that I put back in here. It's just adding more to that. And that's why I put them back in the deck, because I don't want to see more of what I'm seeing here. I want to see an outcome here that will help you understand what you're dealing with so you can go into December. But it looks like you're struggling here, guys, with a situation overall that's bringing you down, that's burdening you, and you're trying to get past it. Something's holding you back. What's the outcome, please? Now, the Page of Wands at the bottom of the deck. Now, this is interesting. You guys are about to start a new path in your lives, a new journey. Absolutely, 100%. And this is what the situation's all about. And that's why I was being all weird and cryptic. Now, the Page of Wands, do you see this picture? This person is taking one last look behind as he continues to go on a new path, a new journey. But somehow is excited about this new path, is excited about this new journey. In fact, this little salamander makes him feel like he's even protected. So he's curious, he's excited. So if I was to give you a feeling of the energy behind this card, it's the kid that just graduated college. Got the world at the palm of their hands. So many opportunities, so many options. What are you going to do? It's the person who just moved to a new area, a new location. So much exploring to do. How much fun. This is somebody who just met somebody new and is excited. Others of you, this is newly single, excited, because nothing's holding you. Well, there is something holding you back, but you're still excited and curious about this new adventure you're about to embark on, this new path in your life. Now, in the recent past, I do see here a King of Pentacles, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. Doesn't have to be. This is just somebody who's stable emotionally and financially. Very practical person. Six of Pentacles, but they were breadcrumbing you. And at some point, you stop talking to this person because maybe you thought it was only physical. Maybe you thought it was just only intimate. So maybe you stopped talking to them and you started debating your pros and cons because the breadcrumbs came. I don't know if you were doing it or if they were doing it, but the breadcrumbs came because somebody was doing it to keep the other person in their orbit. A truth was told. Somebody put their cards on the table. Somebody here came clean. And then there was, you know, good times. This is having fun. This is being casual. This is being frisky. This is not, it's even an affair too. Using intuition, High Priestess, we're not talking to your other person. Weighing your pros and cons here. Do it or don't do it. Breadcrumbs. Let me just throw a text here, a text there, so this person sticks around so I can figure out what I'm going to do. Or they were doing that to you with an earth sign. Because there you are looking at your new path, your new journey. Now in your situation, I have the World, which is definitely a new chapter in your life. Some of you could be traveling too, like far off travels. And the Empress in reverse. I have a lot of feelings off this card. Just give me a moment, because to me this almost feels like insecurities. Like you're curious, you're excited, but maybe not nervous is the right word. I wouldn't say nervous. There's something here that's making you insecure though. Not confident about this new chapter in your life, this new direction that you're going into. You're excited and curious, but you're also feeling a bit insecure. You have some doubts there. But what else am I getting from this card? It's mostly that. I feel like you're here, you're high above, you have some bar that you're at right now, and this is how this person perceives you, as the be-all and end-all. But you don't see yourself that way, Aquarius. You don't see your potential. You don't see your value. You don't see your worth. And you are starting a new chapter. I hope you're not questioning yourself here, Aquarius. Like, am I good enough? Can I do this? Da, da, da. I hope that shit's not running through your head, because that's absolute bullshit. But we'll clarify and we'll see what's going on. Because I have the Four of Pentacles. Maybe some of you are trying to save money for something. Others of you, because, I don't know, tough days. Others of you, maybe some of you see the writing on the wall at work, or your spouse or something like that is affected financially. Others of you, this is clinging on to someone, holding on to somebody energetically. That's what you're going to be doing. What you don't see coming is Temperance sideways and the Eight of Pentacles. You're trying with this new chapter in your life. Like you're trying to move on. You're trying to create new things in your world. And your doubts are coming from this place where your center is not balanced, meaning your core is unbalanced. And that's what's challenging you to find that balance. So in other words, imagine you had an internal compass. Right now, it's going haywire. It's not showing you where your true north is. It's not pointing you in a direction. And because you don't see that direction, because you don't know the course or the path that you need to take, it's giving you these doubts and it's making you unbalanced, uncentered. And this is what's challenging you. And why I use the word challenge is because that's all it is. Doesn't mean you can't conquer it or it's gonna happen to you. It's just your challenge right now. And the Eight of Pentacles, and you're working really hard towards a goal. Either it's a relationship with somebody or your job, your skill, your hobby. And maybe you're thinking of like the direction that you need to go into something, but you can't find your inner compass. You can't find your balance. In fact, you can't even find your patience. When we clarify, we'll see in a moment what this is, but it's challenging you. So the good news is it's neither here nor there in the sense that it isn't happening or it will happen. It's just you are trying to get over it. In your advice is the Devil in reverse and the Seven of Pentacles. So the Seven of Pentacles talks about you needing to pause and reflect on a situation and think about whether you want to invest your time and energy into the situation. A financial product, a financial project, a company, a business, a marriage, a commitment, a person. So it's saying pause, reflect, think. Do you want to invest in this situation? The devil in reverse. Is it toxic to you? Is it deleterious? Is it something that you think of and it makes you want to vomit inside? That would be a peace out to that. That's your advice. Try not to get into something toxic. Try not let the fear get the best of you, because when I see the Empress in reverse and the devil in reverse in your advice, don't let the fear get the best of you. That's where the devil resides. That's the devil's lair. Idle minds, devil's lair, that's kind of what it is. So if you start thinking these negative thoughts about yourself, fear will become the new you, and you don't want that. It will keep you back. So don't think you can't conquer whatever it is that you're thinking about investing your time and energy into. Outcome, lovers, which, by the way, in business can be partners. Other where you have, like, you think eye to eye. You're like two peas in a pod. And the Wheel of Fortune, having serious fucking luck on your side. But in love, this is talking about you having a second chance here with a lover. If not a second chance here with a lover, they're bringing you in a lover. Especially when it's two major arcanas in your outcome. That's why I was like, oh, there it is. Because this is either a second chance or some lucky break between you and a lover. Or karma is bringing you in a lover. This is a bond. It's profound. And you've got three fates working on your behalf to bring in said lover. When I get the lover's card, you've got no fucking choice. Somebody upstairs said, hey, Aquarius and, I don't know, Aries need to meet. They definitely need to meet, either for a reason or a season, either for a lesson or a blessing, one or the other. After the honeymoon phase is over, you decide what you're going to be. But you are definitely meant to meet. This is destiny shit right here in your outcome. This is an actual powerful reading that I'm seeing here. Because there you are on a new adventure. Here you are starting a new chapter in your life. And here you are having some lucky break here with a lover or a partner. That's a profound connection. That's a bond that's unbreakable. Even if you do break up, this is somebody you'll remember until your dying breath, including them. It's not just one-sided. They will always remember you too. There's no way they will. They won't. Not when you have lovers. Now, let's continue and see what's going on here with... And by the way, the lover is not your husband or your wife. It's not even your boyfriend or your girlfriend. It's a lover. This is not a commitment. This is somebody you're connecting to on a deep ass level. But you're probably intimate as well. You're feeling all the feels. Emotional, mental, physical, even spiritual. What's going on here with Aquarius? The World and the Empress in reverse. Do I need to be stand corrected? Oh my God, yes. Oh my God, yes. All right. This reading to me is screaming loud and clear. I have like zero doubts who this reading is for. So if this resonates with you, great, stick with it. If it doesn't, take the advice and go. Now, I mean, run with it, not go away, but you get it. You are starting a new chapter here, and you do have some fear and you do have some doubts. You feel a little insecure because here it is again. I use two different decks for a lot of reasons. For the clarifiers, so I can have maybe possibly both cards come out, the World and the World. So this is for me when spirit doubles down my message. That's why I'm confirming what I'm reading. You're definitely starting a new chapter in your life, but the World doesn't like put you, it doesn't mean that there's connectivity here with somebody yet, just yet. And with that said, this is why you have the Ace of Cups and the Hermit. You have a fresh new start in love here. Either this is a brand new person, and this is why you're excited, or this is a new start with somebody that you've been dealing with. However, unless you're dealing with a Virgo here, the Hermit, you are retracting your energy. You're trying to make a smart decision here. You're trying to do the smart play, the right play. But you're retracting energy. Maybe because somebody here is insecure. Maybe because somebody here has doubts. What I like at the bottom of the deck is the Page of Pentacles. This is what I mean about the World card. No connectivity because there's just potential. That's what the Page of Pentacles is. Potential. Someone's offering something solid. It's not bullshit. It's for real. It's in your world. And it is the potential for this to grow. This little person to grow. That's the potential in this relationship. Growingness. But the Ace of Cups is always just an opportunity. You got to make it happen. The rest is on you. See, fate is lovers. The minor arcana is you. It's your choices. It's your free will. Now, let's see what's going on here with the Four of Pentacles and what the hell it is that you're holding on to here. And see what we need to do about that. What's the Four of Pentacles coming towards Aquarius, please? Oh God, there was something that was burdening you, exhausting you, and you're letting it go. And I don't know, maybe in your mind you're thinking, if I just hold on a little bit more, it will pay off in the future. I don't know why I'm thinking this, but this is the thought that came in my head. Yeah, King of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. Does not have to be. See, the passionate new beginning is not getting off the ground. And I don't know if it's just, it's not happening because somebody's not attracted, or it just hasn't happened yet. Because this King of Cups here is emotionally available. This person's emotionally mature. They're capable of holding on to a relationship. Now, I don't know if this King is holding on to you energetically, or you are holding on to them. But then I have the Ten of Wands in reverse, letting go of burdens, letting go of something that just is mentally and physically exhausting you. Some of you, it can be like you haven't given up. And this is why you're holding on, because you haven't given up because you're thinking something will pay off eventually. If that's not you, then that's what the other person is thinking with you. They haven't let you go because they're thinking that it's going to pay off. Oh my God, my nose is itchy. This is talking about arguments. All right. Temperance, please, and the Eight of Pentacles. So others of you, if this is financial about the Eight of Pentacles, I'm sorry. I know people don't like me mixing up finance and love, but there are two camps, and this is a general audience. But those of you who are working diligently on a craft and it's something that you enjoy doing and you're making money from it, it's saying patience, it'll eventually come in. Others of you where this is love related, like I said before, your inner compass is broken. It's not pointing you to your true north. You can't tell which way is up. You're not sure. So it's challenging you if you should put work and effort into the situation here with someone. And that's why you also have Seven of Pentacles in your advice. You're dealing, some of you could also be dealing with a King of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. So some of you are dealing with two people. One is a relationship and the other is a lover. Or you're debating between the two. No, you're not even debating. You just don't know which way to go. Seven of Swords. This is either you're cheating with this person or sneaking away, ghosting them. But to me, this more looks like cheating. Either they're doing it or you're doing it. This fire sign is cheating and ghosting you, or you're doing it. And you don't know, like, should you work at this relationship? Should you not work at this relationship? Should you let this go? Because these are clarifiers. I don't know. I kind of feel like this fire sign is doing this. And you might be like, you know, but you have the blinders on. Hear no evil, see no evil. It could be either way. But this isn't good with the Seven of Swords. This is ghosting or cheating, this person. Either you're doing it or they're doing it. And you're not certain right now. And you're not balanced. Or you're challenged to get balanced here. What is the, this could even be stealing with money. Interesting. What is the devil in reverse and the seven of pentacles and the advice for Aquarius? All right. So spirits, like, you really do need to think about whether you're going to invest in this future with someone or this project or job or whatever. And you really need to consider getting some rid of something that's toxic within your life. All right. Even if that's the fear in your head. Now, the Page of Swords is also here, which tells me you could be dealing with somebody younger. Others of you, this is really just saying you just need more information is all. You need to just, you know, be a little CIA right now and get your info. Again, you have so many court cards here. It's crazy. And they're all kings, where to me, that's incoming energy. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, like yourself, rushes in to communicate something to you in regards to the past. All right. And the information's going back and forth. And I don't know if you're going to like it. And this is what makes you insecure. When you were just fine. This talks about the past. Somebody comes along and tells you something about the past, about your person. And it throws you off kilter. Fuck them. Don't let that deter you. Just get more information. You don't know what's what. Let's see what's going on with the lovers and you having another opportunity here with this lover. What is the lovers and the Wheel of Fortune, please? Oof. Some of you could be dealing with a Leo also. Six of Pentacles. In reverse, not giving into some kind of commitment or marriage. Somebody's holding back. Somebody's withholding from giving into a marriage, giving into a commitment, putting effort or into the situation. Yeah. There's been a collapse here because of a lover or for a lover. Look at this. Either this ended with a lover or the marriage ended for the lover. Someone's definitely going to get their heart ripped out. Guys, this is at the bottom of the deck. All right? So, this is in the future. For this week, this is what's happening. So, you have a second chance here with a lover because something's not working out in another commitment or marriage with you. Something, like, fucking major happens. Your whole world collapses here. And it's got something to do with the lover. So, either it's ending with the lover or it's ending with somebody committed for the lover. Again, this could be coming from their end or your end. I'm speaking to thousands of you guys, so it's different for all of you. Now, universe, angel, spirit guides, of course, leave me your comments down below. You deserve love. Somebody's been mistreating you. Or you're not getting enough of love. Now, in my extended readings, guys, we deep dive in these cards. We add tarot. We layer over. Because, like I say, love is blind. Oracle isn't. Some people are like, ah, the oracle card. No, the oracle cards are, like, legit. They see things we do not. Even the readers. Sometimes, like, we don't pick up, and they do. And then, in the extended, we layer over. So we can pick up what they really are laying down. Flirt is also here. And at the bottom of the deck, it's make an effort. So I think it's referring to this lover. So I think that you have this opportunity with some lover and it can all go away like this. So it's saying flirt, you deserve love. I feel like spirit's trying to bring you this into your life because something else has affected you immensely. Can I have one more, please? Yeah, very soon and religious factors. Others of you guys, you might be dealing with somebody that is different from you. Culturally, ethnically, economically, academically, whatever. You have a fundamental difference between the two of you. And one of the two of you might not be interested because of, like I said, your religious backgrounds or your ethnicity, whatever it is. So you need to make a decision quickly because to me that sometimes is unrequited love. And again, seeing that information along with you deserve love and flirt, You're giving into a situation that's not fair for you. Now, let me get some advice cards from the Moonology deck. Aquarius, please. And that'll be a wrap. You have two. You have reminder. Oh, wow. I don't need to read from the book for this one, but I will tell you what this is, reminder. Reminder talks about karmic lessons. Reminder talks about you reminding yourself all the things that you've learned from your past in regards to things that work, that don't work, especially when you have you deserve love. Spirit's like saying, remember all of the life lessons you had, all the red flags that you've learned from. Don't repeat those. Do yourself a favor. And the other card is denial. Like I said, to me, this is very much what the Seven of Cups was before, when I saw it at the bottom of the deck. Somebody here, it could be in denial, but I don't think that's what that means in this deck. I think the spirit is denying you for a specific reason. So that I'm going to read. I think you're being denied from the universe for a particular reason because you deserve love. Not everything is in reach, my child. Sometimes I must create distance between what you want and when or how you are meant to receive it. Consider the wait for your highest good. You are not meant to achieve what you want right now. Keep the faith, for if you wait and show patience, I will reveal some wondrous things later. This is a gentle warning not to get caught up in your desire to reach your goal too soon. You may choose sour fruit that only looks ripe and juicy. In this case, I alone know when the time is right. Patience, my child. Patience, my child. You're trying to manifest something, Aquarius, and the timing is not right. You need to be patient. And you can't focus right now because that's what's challenging you on top of you. So don't forget your life lessons. Be patient. You are being denied at the moment because something is being worked out for you. Because you deserve love. And when I see the fucking tower, that means spirit was saying you weren't seeing it. You weren't letting it go. You were dealing with something that was beneath you, which is why you have the Empress in reverse. Because you're an Empress. Kings and queens report to Empresses. And you were dealing with some fucking bullshit. And spirit's like, I gotta take this from Aquarius. I don't need to be with this person. First of all, this person's not elevating because Aquarius is giving them everything. And Aquarius is meant to grow with somebody else. I don't know. Your future readings are going to be very, very interesting to me. All right, guys. Of course, leave me your comments down below. The extended is down there. Everybody else, I'll see you over there.